Thank you. Good morning, everyone. It's no secret, I quantify myself a lot. Actually, I own somewhere around 5 or 6 tracking devices that I can put on my body at a time. That is not including my 3 different heart rate monitors, my cadence sensor on my running shoe, my cadence sensor on my bicycle, and the 6 or 7 apps on my phone that are tracking my screen time at a given moment. It's an obsession. But it's led to some of the most important events in my life. Journaling my diet and tracking my weight loss led to a 30-pound drop. I think the better data I need to collect is how my wife is at times. And tracking my times running, swimming, cycling turned me from couch potato to an Ironman in 18 months. And so I feel really passionately that we can make change through collecting, analyzing, and triangulating data. So I began another experiment just last month, and I'm going to share that with you. I hooked myself up to all of my devices for 24 hours a day for a full week. I had no purpose in mind. I had every app running, every device on me, I'm tracking heart rate, and I started with about 40 variables. I got it down to just 20 that I decided to actually quantify. I was tracking mood, I was tracking productivity, it was everything. And I didn't know what stories were going to emerge from this or how you become a better person, but I'll share with you what I found. First, I visualized it. The best way to look at data is visually. But it was hard to tell the stories. I could see peaks and valleys, I could see shifts, I could see changes. But I didn't really know what was going to work yet, so I started to put the data together. And I went for the obvious correlations first. I looked at my resting heart rate versus how much I exercise, and you can see the lines are moving in opposite. As you expect, if you exercise on those days, your heart rate should drop. I also looked at how if I unlocked my phone more, my productivity score decreased. All of this was to show that my data was working, and that I was doing what it was supposed to do. And so then I made a bit of an eyesore, a correlation table. I correlated all 20 variables with all other 20 variables, and I looked for strong, moderate, weak correlations. I wanted to know what I would find out about myself through looking at these correlations. And there were some startling ones at first. One of the ones I found right away is that I could increase my social influence just by exercising more. So if I maintain a healthier, balanced exercise life, then not only do I have a lower heart rate, but I can probably be a larger charity now. I'm not sure you know. But on the other side of that, apparently my Twitter impact affected my brokerage account. And so now I'm hyperventilating because I'm not sure, do I maintain a healthy life or do I forego my retirement? So I went back to the drawing board. I decided to focus on just one thing. Focus on my mood. What makes me happy? And I found that my mood extremely strong positive correlation with my previous night's sleep. And if I had a good day, my next night's sleep was better. And that I could influence all of that by putting away my phone more. The more I open my phone, the less I sleep. And there's one other one that I found that increased my mood. I was spending time with my wife. And here I am in front of all of you, admitting in my story that, no secret, that putting your phone down more, spending more time with the people that matter, will improve the quality of your life. I'm also admitting in front of you that for a moment, I thought that I had, my Twitter had control over financial markets of the world. But that's my story. Each of you has an individual story. And your students have stories around this data. And you're collecting data on yourselves and on them. It might be gradebook data, it might be standardized testing data. But we need to start connecting the dots, putting the pieces together in that puzzle, and see what might emerge. And it might not always make sense. So a project I did with a team of teachers, we made a wellness survey. It's a micro survey. We deployed this every 2 to 3 weeks, and we surveyed them around enjoyment, confidence, support. We wanted to know their perspectives, and we wanted it to be agile, so that we could see real-time changes. And we found that when we correlated that and did a micro survey on teachers, that their dips correlated times when teachers said they were busy. So when you're feeling it, they're feeling it. goes hand in hand with some of the work from Kevin Crouch on Consilience Learning, where they took polls of hundreds of teachers and they correlated teachers who believed they were well prepared, which are on the left, with teachers who believe they are not well prepared, which you see on the right. And you can see their feelings around, it's the reverse. Your well prepared teachers are on the right, and your teachers who indicated they were not well prepared on the left. Teachers who felt well prepared indicated more strongly that technology made them a clever teacher. I had a teacher in fifth grade put Xiaomi wristbands on their students, and now students are tracking how their sleep affects their academics, and vice versa, how their academics affect their sleep. We need to start putting those pieces together. It might not always make sense. And I challenge you to think about what data you have that you could connect. I want to know, how does your cafeteria data line up with your behavior data? I want to know how active your school is during a week affects heart rates. And I want to know how your teacher wellness affects your standardized test scores. I don't really know what you're